Last of Us 2. Starting a little late today because there was a software update on the PlayStation. But we're nearing the end of this game. This is, we're with Abby and Mel now. So, Abby just mentioned something about a catwalk. And Mel's over on the boat. So, it looks like I can just hoist this. Use those forearm muscles, Abby. Alright, now I'm a caper tosser. Awesome. Looks like I might be able to, like, place it against the rail here. I think that yellow up there is where we want to get. Is there a near spot on... where to put this, there we go. It's like a painter's plank. And it's designed to be light, but it's still, what, like 12 feet long? Alright, where to from here? I might need a hint at some point, but... again, I might not. What if I... that's an awfully far drop. I don't think I want to just drop down that. Oh. Apparently when the controller starts to shake, Abby is losing her balance. Okay. Well, let's try that again. So, I want to get up to the yellow one. Get off of this. Can I pick up the plank? No. So it looks like I'm pretty restricted here. It's not letting me shift off. So, looks like I can be nice and steady when I'm on the painter's plank. There. So, are there other pieces, parts of the boat that I can lay the plank from? Looks like there's also a rope on the boat. That's interesting. So, can I place the plank here? No. It looks like only here can I really place the plank. But then there is a rope here.
It's promising.
You're darn right, it's promising, Mel. Oh, if I throw the rope over the girder, then I can climb down from the girder once I've used the plank to get over there. So... throw the rope, and then cross the plank, and then I use the rope to go down? No. Maybe I need to throw the rope higher. Maybe I need to use it to climb up. It's okay, Abby. We're fine. No, I want to grab the rope. Alright, let's put the plank right back where it was.
See.
Yump. And up and up and up. Wait, is Mel really gonna, like, climb the rope? I guess.
Long way down. Vertigo hitting me hard. Especially when I look down.
Yeah. Abby doesn't like heights. Nice and steady. Nice and steady.
There they are. Manny, be right down.
Okay.
Look, Fob, sweet Fob. What is there?
Fob, sweet Fob.
Cut through that rail yard.
Forward operating base.
Please. It's kind of hard to imagine you being afraid of anything. I'm not as fearless as you think. Oh, please. Like, I could never do the surgery stuff you do. I'd be too freaked out about fucking it up.
You think I don't feel the same way?
Well, for what it's worth, my dad always said you were his best student.
He did? Well, he always said he was an idiot. Come on.
I think that's Bear down there.
Alice,
right. We look Bear back at the base.
Been quiet out here?
Yeah. I don't like
it. Oh, we're almost to the fog.
Almost to the
fog. We get back home. We're gonna find a couch, watch a movie, and drink until I pass out.
Oh, Manny.
Oh, yeah? Which drink? Which movie?
Strong questions. The movie's the one with... ¿Cómo se llama? The girl who writes the wall.
Oh, I love that one.
Drink. My mezcal from the party last week.
Excuse me? You mean our mezcal?
Say it, I'll save some for you.
Oh, I can definitely go for a drink right now.
If I wasn't so pregnant.
Smoky cactus juice. Oh, Alice. Getting in the way. Wonderfoot.
Guys, down this way. Okay, we'll follow the tracks. That'll get us back on the main road to the fog.
I don't like this.
I know. Keep your eyes open. Anywhere over that wall?
Not that I can see.
Seraphites. They're sweeping this way. I can get under that train car.
Thank you.
bullets in the rifle. Pick and pull on those. Some radar. Just friends. Oh, okay, there we go. Got his back to me now. This one's tall. Trust Manny to clear an area. Where's that coming from? That's it for rifle bullets.
Holy shit. That it?
I don't see any more.
On me. Let's go. Guys, up here. We're almost there.
Puta madre. They're close.
That's some whistling, all right.
Through here.
Hey, let me see your hand.
We're in.
Squeeze this as hard as you can, okay?
Holy shit.
I didn't even feel it. Hey! We got two. Okay, he's got a gunshot wound to the hand.
Almost a compliment.
Go get help.
Stay, Alice.
Come on, it's this way. Sit.
Alice is a good dog.
Almost blood bladder, right?
She shouldn't be out.
She'll be okay. She'll be okay.
Here.
Hey, come on, girl. This is Alice. Come on, Alice. Good girl.
Thank you.
These new recruits. I don't trust them.
Thanks again, guys.
Checking in. Hey, you two.
What you got for us?
No assignment. Just says report to Isaac.
Both of us?
Yeah.
Isaac.
He's busy.
Someone's going down.
Verifying Isaac.
We should make sure Will's okay first.
Where's the med tent?
Yeah? Heard about your ambush. Heard they hit you.
Right around here. Near the warehouses.
Oh, shit. They keep slipping past our lines.
Hey, you know where Isaac is?
He was here a few minutes ago.
Okay, thanks. We'll look around.
There's medical.
Hey, man. Feeling better?
Pain meds are kicking in, so... yeah.
Hang in there.
How's the hand?
I'm gonna keep most of my fingers.
Brother, you only need three. Am I right?
Two.
I smell. Shouldn't take the alcohol from the med tent. Hey, Manny.
I'm stopping for a bus. She's
of the med tent? There it is.
Speak of the devil. Hey, guys.
How you doing, Melon?
Just a few more stitches, and I'll be good as new.
You guys need to convince this girl to relax.
Hey, Mel. Relax. You got it.
I need some muscle, so you two give me a hand or something.
Sure.
Don't move.
We'll just be here. Relaxing.
Nora, have you had a chance to relax?
I'm shipping out to the Westside Hospital in a few. Orders are to get everything.
Nora.
How's Mel? Really?
Well, the baby's vitals were a little elevated, but I'm not worried.
Someone should get word to Owen. I want to be here for
it. Yeah. I need to show you guys something.
What is it?
Follow me.
Oh my god.
It's a lot of body bags.
Yeah. And we're coming in by the hour. You can't tell Mel. All right?
Nora.
Just not yet. Come here.
Who's in that body bag?
Is it Alli?
Holy shit. It's Danny.
Where's Alli?
Back, there were some scar sightings out by the marina. Danny and Owen were sent on a sweep. And this morning, the guards found Danny collapsed by the perimeter fence. He'd walked himself back with a bullet in his stomach.
Pinches scars, hijos puta.
Isaac talked with him until he passed, but as far as I can tell, there's no units going back that way.
So what about Owen? Did you ask Isaac what happened?
Yeah, I tried. But he gave me that fucking look, and then he told me to keep quiet about it. Which means you can't say shit.
Owen's a big boy. I'm sure he's fine.
Where is Isaac? I'll be discreet.
Last I heard, he was in the apartments. I'm gonna go check up on Mel, so. Let me know what you guys find out.
Yeah. Why the hell hasn't Isaac set out a search party for Owen?
Maybe he hasn't, just even told Laura.
I fucking hope so.
Isaac?
We're looking for Isaac.
He's inside. Go in.
Thank you.
Damn, look who it is.
Sup, fellas?
Got time for a game?
Can't. Here for Isaac.
Whatever, big shot.
Not my fault I'm so good at what I do.
Mm-hmm.
See you around.
Does it say? Isaac, took 3 days, but I finally got something out of number 74. If what he's saying is true, sounds like the southern shore might be our best bet. I've marked up a map and left it in your suite. We should send scouts to verify as soon as possible. I still feel like he might be holding out. Give me a few more days with him. Sergeant Foster. No backside of it. I don't think I like Sergeant Foster.
I don't miss this place. Fuck. Always hating this man.
After our warning, Owen might a few minutes with these guys.
I
here. Oh, there's scars. Seraphites. Alright. I just got a lot of guards.
Hey, Abby.
We need to go up.
Hazuk's in there.
Oh. Do you know if he'll be long?
Said again when you two arrive.
What is he in the middle of? I'm not gonna like it, am I?
Sir, have you been here?
I already don't like it.
Two ran into some trouble.
No losses on their side. Just some minor injuries. Can't say the same for them.
Wish I was hearing more of that.
This guy's a general.
Raise this back.
Give it another day. Still waiting on some units.
What's going on, boss?
Small skirmishes. Can't keep going like this.
Then what?
We could try another truce. Not long before some asshole on their side or our side unravels the whole thing.
Sir, we'll try attacking the island.
Not like this. Not with everyone. It's a big storm, a few days out. We're gonna use it to mask our approach. You two are gonna lead the first wave. Pick your squads, start prepping.
I want Owen. When are he and Danny getting back? Sent a search party on the trip.
They shot Danny. Apparently to protect some scar.
It's bullshit.
Excuse me.
It's not Owen. You got it wrong.
You're saying Danny used his last breath to lie to me.
Sir, people hear that story. Owen's dead. Anyone who finds him, they'll gun him down for sport.
And I suggest you all stop gossiping about it.
Let me go after him. I'll walk him back in. We'll get to the
No.
Bottom. You said yourself the storm's a few
No.
days.
We've only got one shot at this.
One opportunity.
This is bigger than any of us. Definitely bigger than Owen. If he turns up, then fine. Give him the benefit of the doubt, and we'll get to the bottom of it. I need you, Abby. Yeah.
Yeah. I get it.
Good. Look over the plans, go through your roster. Grab some food. Talk later.
No way you're gonna kill Danny or some scar, right? What? Don't.
I'll be back by morning. You just gotta cover me till then.
Isaac will kick your ass.
I pray, Assault. He heard him, he needs me.
If Owen's out there, how the hell are you going to find him?
I know where he'll go.
Why don't you come on over and enjoy this view with me, then?
It's great. Maybe when it stops rocking?
Oh. Come on. We made it all the way up here just so you could wimp out on the last two steps.
Yeah. Yes, the deal was to get up here, so.
All right, here's what's gonna happen. You're gonna get your ass over here. Sit on the edge, or you can go down here on the kid seat. And look at this view with me.
You can't miss training.
Really? Not even just for one night?
No.
Talk about it?
It's getting late. Don't. Do not. It is too high.
Oh, my God. You know, I don't think I can live like this anymore, Abby.
Owen, I'm serious. I will break up with you. Owen.
I always loved you.
Don't! Owen!
Do it, Abby. It's just like 3 or 4 or 6 times the normal high dive.
Oh my God.
Yeah, let's do this thing. Where is he?
Abby!
Down here, you asshole.
You jumped? And I missed it?
I thought you drowned.
And you came to my rescue?
No. I came to make sure you drowned.
I found something pretty awesome.
What?
I think you're gonna have to follow me to see it.
Owen, we have to go back.
We will. Once you see this.
Owen.
What are they gonna do? Kick out a bunch of displaced fireflies with nowhere else to go?
Maybe. I don't want to find out.
Just come see this thing.
Deep breath.
Track of them. I don't like it.
gonna keep going?
Fuck yeah.
It's like one of those zoos, but for fish.
It's a fish zoo.
Check this water pup out. I saw the seal the other day. It's covered in spots.
They don't have spots. They're brown.
Those are sea lions.
No. No, you don't know.
I know what I saw with my eyes.
Oscar, baby fur seal. Alright, we're just looking around or what? On with the... Still hung up on this seal sea lion thing? Minnow. Sea otter. Seal. Now, where the hell did Owen go? Owen, where are you? There he is. What you got? Bub, baby river otter. What a cutie. Peanut, the baby sea otter. Ooh, there's a door.
Hey, give me a hand with this.
Yep.
Together.
What is this place?
Well, clearly this is some sort of theater, but for fish.
Yeah, it's a fish theater.
What? Are you a rooster?
What? I'm a wolf. That's my wolf howl.
You're an
what
idiot.
A goofball. It's too bad.
I think this sailboat was part of the show.
No, looks like somebody turned this into a midship dock or something.
Kid clothes.
There's some kids' clothes. Bet a family came through.
Look at these drawings.
I wonder what happened to them.
Maybe they joined the wolves.
Yeah, or got killed by scars.
Such an optimist.
Time to go.
All right. Enough of this boat. You want to go see the rest of the fish zoo?
You think
yes,
there's
I
more
do.
To see?
Of course. Let's go.
Left or right? Right or left? Go right. That's just how we got out into the fish theater. Right. Anything interesting at the souvenir kiosk? Hey, Owen, you want a souvenir? Slip and slide for sea lions. Field trips meet here.
Think you can get through that?
Get me up there.
Yep.
Here.
Shit! Look at you!
Pushed 185 pounds yesterday.
Yeah, right.
Oh, come on. You can't do 185,
so,
Owen.
We take a quick look around and then...
You head right back.
Uh-huh.
Except that this is nothing, and you're gonna beg me to stay.
Not happening.
Just wait.
Whales.
See that every day. What the heck is this place?
It's a tank in the floor.
Can you imagine this place filled with people? Kids laughing, running around. Different world, right? I'm claiming this place. It's mine. You can visit.
Oh, you're sure?
You can visit.
Not really, actually. Let's see how nice you are to me first.
You're a dick.
Not a great start.
Fine. Is there a zebra? Kids, if you find this, I want you to know I don't blame you. Those Seraphites are selling a good line. I understand why you thought you'd be better off with them. There's food and water in the boat. Take it and sail away from this place. I know I got too controlling. I just wanted so much for you two to be safe. I hope you see that. I couldn't find antibiotics. I want you both to know I love you. Ricky, keep watching out for Max. You owe him that. Dad. Well, I wonder what Dad needed antibiotics for. Himself or somebody else?
I think it's the same family from the boat.
That'd be my guess, yeah.
Ricky and Max. Hmm. Well, this is Max's place. Rooms are all overgrown and closed off.
We have to come back here with the others.
That's good, yeah. Get them to break the rules, too.
You don't think it's worth it?
Let's see how much trouble we're in when we get back.
Huh. You love it.
Shut up.
So, can I get like a... Owen, you were right. Thanks for dragging me in this amazing place.
I'll think about it.
I'll think about it. It's like a buffet. Probably we got mixed. What is this? The corn husks? Condiments. I mean, corn husks could last a good long time. That's this must be Dad.
I think this is our boat, Captain.
Shit.
Dad, I'm taking Max away from here. He can't spend his life locked inside this rotting building. All he'll do is take on your weaknesses. When the soldiers killed Mom, you just stood there like a coward. What kind of example is that? You should have gotten away. You should have made them hurt worse than they hurt her. I want Max to see what it looks like when people are willing to stand up for what they want, when they're willing to make something of their life. The world is harsh. It's up to us to change it. Only when weak may I carry my true strength. Maybe we'll be back someday. If we do, I hope you're not still sitting in your stupid fucking chair. And then there's a Seraphite sign.
His kids are enough to join the Scars.
Jeez. Hmm. Well, on the bright side, family's keys.
What's wrong with you?
He's a skeleton. He doesn't need them.
I just don't understand how anybody willingly joins the Scars.
Why not?
Because they're an insane cult. That's why.
I mean, the QZs, people would refer to the Fireflies as terrorists. Fanatics.
We were naive. We weren't fanatical.
We blew up checkpoints and assassinated soldiers.
It's not the same.
I'm just saying...
Don't say shit like that at the stadium, okay?
Okay, fine.
What time do you think it is?
I don't know. We got time.
It's a pretty cool picture. Astronauts and a fish. Like a space fish. One missed target. Thank you. Seems like Ricky had more mature tastes than Max. Probably about mid-teens when they went to the Seraphites. Got the keys. Whales are big. Alright, give me the keys, Owen.
Wanna try those keys?
Oh, yeah. This one? Nope. Out. Got it. This must have taken forever.
What you got there, Owen? No, don't. You're gonna fall. Don't do it. Just stay away from the elevator shaft, Owen.
Last thing. I promise.
Last thing.
Just, don't look down.
Just go.
You're good. Get on in here.
It's a dome. Yeah. Oh, it does have spots.
See that? Told you there was potty.
Yeah.
It's mochi time.
No.
Is it this? It's this, isn't it? You are disgusted by it. Come on.
I'm sorry.
Don't be sorry. Talk to me.
Owen's being a good guy. When did this start happening?
I know all the leads have dried up. But Joel's still out there, you know?
I know. Okay.
Let's go back. We can still make training.
Grant.
What about you?
I'm gonna hang out with the SEALs for a little while.
I'm sorry.
Owen's somewhere else.
He's there.
Let's get up the roof before someone sees us. Can I talk you out of this?
No. We don't know what happened. I gotta find him.
I mean, if you really killed Danny...
Fuck Danny. I'm jealous Owen got to shoot him before I did.
Whoa, Abby.
I do appreciate you helping me sneak out like this.
How are you getting to the quarry? Highway?
Shit.
Can't. Too many patrols. I get spotted for sure. I'll rough it. Aquarium's due west of here. Keep following the sun, right?
The one Seraph I...
I've done this before.
No, we just didn't discuss in the area.
...would shoot somebody for... All right. ...is Max.
You know best.
Owen found Max. Damn.
This way.
Hey. Thanks.
This?
Yeah, and other stuff, you know. You're a good friend.
Come on, Ash. You know I can't handle all this emotion.
Alright, where to next?
Looks clear. Come on.
Up we go.
Wish me luck.
When you find him, I'm heading to her.
I'll do my best.
Seriously, watch yourself out there.
See ya. Okay.
Just around
the sunset.
Coming from.
What is that smell?
It's like a clothier's shop, dressmakers. Through here with Alli. The turnstile have for me. I'll almost certainly block.
Figures. Guess I'm going over that wall.
somehow. Let's see what this Fender truck has for me. The glass, but it doesn't get me anywhere. Back to the Fender truck. Doses, blades, duct tape, very good. Check out this end of the wall first. May she guide you. Well, can I not turn around here? Second, I don't have much hat up. One moment, let's see if I can pull it up on the iPad. I had my laptop doing it, but the laptop ran out of battery. So, what we got here? Twitch app. Press on my avatar. worries. So, all right, I've got my chat up. Good morning, Waji. How's it going? So I missed what you said, but actually, I wonder. Maybe next time I'll set it so that I can see the chat messages on the PlayStation. That'd be cool. Let's see, upgrades. Just said sup. Yeah, sup sup. How you doing? Listen mode clarity, that seems like a good thing to learn. Can I get hold breath? Oh. Alright. Here we go. Get my upgrades. Going through the narrow part. The seraphites all seem to revere this lady, and she's got a very specific face.
That guide you right off a cliff. These freaks are in our backyard.
Hearing anybody? No. You had a horrible week, oh no. Oh, yeah. That thing snowballed and you got stressed a lot and work pressure and everything. Well, I hope that you're having a good weekend to decompress from it all. Never gonna have crappy weeks? If only it were that simple, Waji. I mean, there is a lot to be said for just kind of shaping your attitude to do things, but, you know, Things will happen. I suppose what you do have control over is how things affect you. So here's to not having crappy weeks. First glass of wine in 11 days. Congratulations. Runners going on here. We got just the two of them. Okay, there's a third. Looks like a runner, not a clicker. Lost weight, is that a good thing? Is that a goal of yours? I mean, sometimes losing weight is healthy. Sometimes losing weight is a problem. But I hope it's a good thing. Yeah. So tell me, what kind of wine did you have? Hotel for Wednesday and Thursday. So Thursday is off and our weekend is Friday and Saturday. Nice. So yeah, a little bit of treat yourself. Yeah. Yeah, sometimes you gotta do that. Just kinda have a bit of a luxury experience. Fungus people of White Sancerre. I don't know if I've ever had that. That sounds like, so describe that to me. Is it dry or sweet or does it have a bit of that kinda vermouthy nose to it? There's certain whites that have this The only way I know to describe it is like a wormwood thing going on. Dry and pretty awesome. I'm gonna have to try that out, see if I like it. I mostly gravitate toward reds and rosé, but some are aromatic too. Excellent. Yeah. Next time I do a wine order, I'm gonna add some white Sancerre to the list. See what I can get. That one's gonna see me. It's mad. So, you know, booking a hotel room is not something I would have thought of, but it's a great idea. A month or so, you had a very nice rose wine called Otto, with a star, it says, an asterisk instead of the last O. Pretty expensive. So are we talking like $50 a bottle expensive? $100 a bottle? More? Otto, like the Italian word for eight. 50 plus size? Yeah, that's a pretty expensive wine. Like, not the sort you're gonna buy every day. That's a reasonable threshold there. But like, you can get a decent bottle of wine for $10 sometimes. But like 12 to 14, I feel like $15 wine is a decent everyday drinker. Or I say everyday in a sort of loose sense. I certainly don't drink wine every day myself. I suppose having a glass or two every day is not excessive. All right. All these narrow places. Squeezing through. This is a nice courtyard. So I was thinking about what you said about booking a hotel room. Is there anything I can drag over there? Second sip and now you're tipsy. That's the wonderful thing about going without for a while. Your tolerances change. Alright. So it looks like can I get over here? Oh yeah. Alright. So going back to hotel rooms, that's a decent idea. Like, I might steal that idea, because at my apartment I've got a shower, but I've got no tub for a bath, so if I wanted to, like, have a nice soak, I don't have the equipment for it, but a hotel room with a nice big bathtub could be just the thing. Hey there, Nick. Which of us is completely unknown person? Me? Or Waji? Or Abby here? Bubble baths. Yep. Like, when I was a kid, I never took showers as a kid. It was always baths. And then, like, at some point in adolescence, I switched. I just flip-flopped. Just always showers, never baths. And later in my adulthood, I kind of missed that bath experience. Getting your fingers and toes all pruny and wrinkly. And kind of a soothing bubble bath addition, if you want. Oh yeah, all of us. It's just, hey stranger. In a bathtub, yeah. So, to my mind, a shower is like you're standing up, the water's coming out from above you, and you just sort of let it wash over you, and it's like a quick way to bathe oneself. Whereas a bath is where you, like, you draw water into the tub, you get it up to a certain level, a certain heat. Ah, yeah. Baths can be pretty wonderful, because, like, you just kind of soak. You're like a, I don't know, like a tea bag soaking in a cup of tea. And especially if you add certain, like, there can be moisturizing additives you can pour in, and bubble stuff. Bubble baths are fun, because you get to, like, shape the bubbles into foam and stuff. They're very luxurious. And, like, if you have a nice, like, board or something set up, you can even read in the bath. Like, you just lounge in the tub, have some kind of support to keep the book or Kindle or whatever you're reading on dry. Don't drop it in the tub. That reminds me of a story from my childhood. So, as I said, when I was a kid, I always took baths, not showers.
Damn it.
My dad had made a board that was just fitted correctly for our tub to lay across the tub, and you could put things on it, like books and stuff. And so I had a library book about planes, airplanes, and it was a wonderful picture book. There's a picture book about airplanes, and I was reading it in the tub, and I can learn to make shivs. That's unfortunate. So anyway, here I was in the bath, reading this book about airplanes, and being a, like, 6 or 7 year old kid, I was not the most adroit with my limbs, and I knocked the book off into the water. So we ended up having to pay the library for that book. I think it was like $35 to replace the airplane book, which to me, as a 6 year old in 1984, was a lot of money. Hotels costing $540, including tax, for 2 nights. Yeah, I mean, that's what, like, $250 a night, plus some? Basically the fanciest place. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that is definitely worth it for a... Why am I so bad at aiming? Jeepers creepers. Reloaded recently. having 3 shots is not good enough. 4 shots, okay. I'm pretty sure this pistol can do more.
Damn it. Just stay out of my way.
You've lived in have had showers. Yeah, so I guess it's maybe more common than I thought. Just having a standing stall. No tub at the bottom. So the house I grew up in. House I grew up in. It was a shower above a tub, so you could stand in the tub to take a shower, or you could fill it up with water to have a bath. Alright, I think I'm just gonna ignore those. This isn't my patch. Hotel equals tub time. Yeah. Nice. I mean, if it's something you don't normally have, it can be nice to indulge in something a little different. Of like the painting of Mount Fuji. That's not really a door. Well, this is the way I came. That's the way I arrived. So, it's over here. So crafting materials, that's good. Further into the back of that kind of hotel area. If I can just get by this way. Yep.
Drew's his dad, but they just keep coming back here. Can we just clean all this shit up?
Jinglies. And a note. My prophet, I ask that you grant me, may you bring me, all struck out. Perhaps what I ask is impossible. Perhaps what I ask is impossible, but I must ask. Bless the wolves with your insight, with your wisdom, with your love. That they might renounce their selfish ways and lay down their arms. May you bring peace to this world. I mean, that's a lovely sentiment.
You want peace?
But...
easy. Stay on your island.
Well, when people come at each other with guns, peace is not forthcoming. Thanks for the note. Appreciate it. Can't wait to see you again. Meanwhile, I'm still stuck guarding the Scar Prophet. I didn't tell you this, but on the last shift I talked to her. I asked her, why is she doing this? Why doesn't she ask her people to lay down their arms? She started off with the usual Scar BS, how we need to go back to nature, talked a bunch about the reliance we have on machines, but then she said she doesn't want a war, that Outbreak Day was a wake-up call, but not all of us woke up, or something like that. It was just getting interesting when fucking Lewis walks in and gives me shit about talking to her. But when he started screaming at her, she just smiled back at him. Even when they moved her cells and the other guards were calling her names and pushing her around, she just kept that calm smile from Spooky. Everyone says she's crazy, but I'll tell you. Tell you what, after hanging out with her, I get what she's saying. Don't get me wrong, I think all her followers are fucking loons. But she has a way about it and draws you in. I hear rumblings that they want to move her to a more secure location. See you back home. Be careful, Sally. Alright.
Isaac.
Alright.
You turned a crazy person into a martyr.
Oh dear, dear, oh dear. This is what happens. Are these foot baths? Neat. The pedicure. I haven't seen a workbench in a while. I've been collecting a bunch of scrap parts. Alright, so this is the other side of that turnstile. What's that? Crowbar. Well, my pipe's almost out of durability, so I may as well grab the crowbar. What do I have here? I should make sure this is fully loaded. Time playing as Abby falling off high ledges. Yeah, well, Abby doesn't like heights. Gordon Freeman is pleased. Plus 10. it's the red painted one with the like hardened tips and. Trying to hug a clicker never gets old. Yeah. Those clickers in there, it told me I needed a shiv to take them down from stealth, but I don't know how to make shivs, so that's a problem. Alright, I'm on the gateway here. Yeah, high ledge. Jump off. that's a generator, but I don't think it's... Oh. Abby's on alert. Why are we on alert? Elder Scrolls, you say? So, are you talking Elder Scrolls 1 Arena? Elder Scrolls Online? Elder Scrolls 5 Skyrim? Elder Scrolls 4 Oblivion? Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind? My friend Nefastu plays Elder Scrolls Online quite a bit. I guess there are horses that you can tame in ESO. What's up, Noder? How's it going? Khajiit is here if you have coin. Yeah. I feel like Morrowind is about when Elder Scrolls kind of came into its own. Gardening time. Oh, that sounds nice. So, do you have gardens for food or for, like herbs or flowers or what? Or like a mushroom garden. That'd be kind of cool. Nice. Yeah. Food gardens are lovely to have. And like, having your own spices, being able to cook with stuff that you know you grew with your own hands. It's good stuff. So what's the principle here is that when you garden topless, the plants grow better? So that now actually reminds me of a place that I lived. So probably about 7 or 8 years ago now, I lived in Stowe, Massachusetts, which is kind of... not quite eastern Massachusetts, but not quite central Massachusetts. And I lived with, so my landlady and her boyfriend had this great big house. And so her boyfriend Tom actually went by Tommy, even though he's probably a 65, 70-year-old dude, likes to garden in the nude, just completely naked. And so... one time, one of my roommates was getting home at an odd hour, and there was Tommy out in the garden, just wearing nothing at all. I think I made for a brief awkward moment, but it's something that you find amusing and then move on from. That's some more Seraphite whistling. This guy who had a partner. I mean, he was alright. He was a very tall guy. Long, flowing white hair. I hope my hair looks as good when I'm in my 60s. But, he had that kind of like... Gandalf. Oh, no, she found him. Quiet. freighted. Or frightened. Alright, who's out here? Where are they? I hear some whistling. Oh, you DM'd for the first time last week. I want to hear all about it, Waji. Tell me. Your first time DMing. Was it the beginning of a campaign? And who all played with you? Good stuff. Oh, yeah. Noter, were you part of the game? Were you a PC in that game? Seraphites are, what they're doing. Just a homemade one shot. That's cool. Yeah. So what kind of setting is it? Completely homebrew. And did you manage to do a total party wipe? Nyloth going Roberto. Hubbled, artificer, alchemist. Alright, so she didn't see me, but she saw the bodies.
Scour this entire area, every building. Someone snuck past us.
Sneak, snack, snuck. Wait for Seraphites to come in here. Choke them out one by one. Why did you cast a level 3 fireball on yourself, Nick? sleep spell. Yeah, I mean, some of the more kind of innocuous spell. Oh, wild magic. Yep, that'll do it. That'll do it. Roll a 1 on that d20 and see what happens. Alright, that one's gonna be coming up the stairs. Who sees me?
There's a wolf here too!
Is a wonderful, so you just gotta be careful not to put your allies to sleep as you're casting your sleep spell. Alright, so I can craft a health kit now. I can craft 2 health kits. As first time DMing, you think it was in your comfort zone, like the topic of the one shot and the idea behind it, but you think sticking to a module might be a better idea? I mean, If you've got an idea for an adventure, that is way better than any module, in my opinion. Like, modules can be a help if you're like stuck for an idea, or if you really, really want to have all the materials prepped. So one thing that modules bring with them that's really nice is just all the maps and the handouts and stuff. But yeah, it's just so much more satisfying, I think, to make up your own. And like, how did she even get it? These Seraphites have good hairstyles. Give them that. Yeah, I mean, I don't know, there's a lot to be said for either way of doing it, of making up your own or using prepared materials. But I feel like if you if you have an idea for a thing, and even if it's your first time, and you, like, as you said, you're comfortable with the idea and the setting, that's a good way to go about it. To help practicing DMing, because making the maps and making up the plan, it's hard to do from scratch. Yeah, with the module, it's kind of like studying and presenting. Yeah, it does actually, it leads to different styles of DMing. Like, I find that I engage in different sort of patterns of activity, whether if I'm working from a module or if it's completely just stuff that I've invented. How many more Seraphites are they going to send here? Yeah, so, my friend Delirious Delight has a blog about gaming, I think it's been almost a year now since the article I'm thinking about, but Del wrote this thing about plotters versus pantsers. Where there's kind of two ends of a continuum of styles of GMing, where the pantser style is flying by the seat of your pants. You're just like making it up as you go along. Like, you might have some sort of sketched in ideas for like what the setting is, what the characters are. not ponzos, but like. Those who go with the pantsing style, although ponzers are kind of fun as vehicles with guns on top, but yeah, I myself, when I'm DMing, tend to favor more improvisational. Just like, I've got a vague idea of what's going on, but I'm just gonna go with the flow in the moment and kind of figure it out from there, but it's a different experience, different thing if there's if I put some planning into it, and then like, okay, I know that they're in this section of an area and it's gonna look like this. Maybe it's a city block, and I've designated all of the buildings along this block. Like, some of these are residences, some of them are shops, and I've got floor plans for the ones that are more interesting, and I've got like a few characters statted out, full character sheets and everything. So yeah, it's certainly possible to do it both ways, and it's possible to mix. Who's whistling and where are they? It's definitely possible to mix them together to good effect.
No mercy for you.
Do I have what I need for a silencer? I don't have enough frags. I bet I can grab this one. Somebody was seeing me a little bit while I was doing that. Where are they? Yeah, and another thing to keep in mind is that there are as many ways to run D&D as there are DMs, and then some. So, as Nick was saying, experiment, go wild, and some sessions will be great, some sessions will be good, some sessions will be a flop, and you kind of roll with the punches and do what you can. But It sounds like y'all had a good time. So what was the setting? Tell me more about like what the beginning and middle and end of this this adventure was. Have your two hotel nights already planned out? First day you check in at 2 p.m., continue work till 5, then take a shower and dress up and go have a weird fun cocktail at the bar. Pasta for dinner, wine, and then soak in a bubble bath. That sounds luxurious as heck, and like a great way to spend a couple of days. And I look forward to hearing what cocktail. What is it? Weird fun cocktail. Yes. So you're just gonna ask the bartender to make you something interesting, whatever they feel like, or try to find the most fun cocktail on the menu. Read a bit, then roll around in bed. Yeah. Do nothing except be alone with your thoughts. Some Eggs Benedict. Oh, Eggs Benedict. Oh, you're making me hungry, Waji. Sweet salmon and a mimosa. Yeah. Replenish those vitamins, vitamin C. So, Waji, this sounds like an amazing couple of days. I heartily approve of this plan. Oh gosh, it's noon. I should probably call it here since it's lunchtime here. Research lab. An interesting place. Alright, I'm gonna take down this one Seraphite and then I'm gonna call it. So, I hope you guys had a good time watching, and I'm thrilled vicariously on your behalf, Waji, for this hotel thing. All right. Yeah, I gotta go because it's lunchtime. But it's been real. So I'll be around tomorrow morning for Hades. And tomorrow evening, I think we're doing Dark Souls, so yeah. Have a good day, everybody. Thank you for watching, and I will catch you next time.